Hi there folks, welcome back to this let's play of Civilization 5, Gods and Kings. This is part 3 and I'm not quite sure where we left off with what we are doing at the moment, but I'll be sure to pick it up soon. Alright, Pakal has completed Stonehenge. Your influence with Genoa is nearly decayed to the point where you're no longer friends. Oh well, got plenty of happiness. So I was exploring. Oh, and this is the end of the continent again. Let's build something. Oh, I have to make sure to wipe out these barbarians. Those guys are healed. I already have a religion. And this guy just now completed the fencing. Okay, so there's nothing left to explore here. Might as well embark. See if there's anything else to explore. Maybe some ancient ruins on some deserted island. Granary, nice. Let's make a library. So we can get some more research. Get a technological. Kill barbarians. And they're almost dead. 8.1 HP. Oh no. Holy. The Oracle, of course. Free social policy is pretty nice. I am ally with Rio de Janeiro. How come? I killed some barbarians, I suppose. Do we get from them extra food? Cool. Incense. Golden Age, probably my last one I'll ever get in this game, because I was struggling with happiness because I have too much cities, too many cities, too many civilians, inhabitants. Oh well. And let me just check out what bonus I got. Plus 2 science. Different. Religious center. Alright. It's pretty cool. Hey. See? I'm allied with him. Only 50 influence. Let's try and I get some more from killing these archers.
The merchants and the traders have come. This life of man appears for a short space.
Which is awfully weak. I do have 2 upgrades and some bonus against barbarians though. Choose research. La 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 la. Engineering. looks like it's good for me. Okay, Iron Working, I wanna build the Colossus. Trading post. Grab the bloody. What do I need a trading post for? Oh well. Just make it build improvements automatically. I've set my settings so that they can't remove existing tile improvements or forest and jungle and marsh, such things, that they can't remove that. Because, you know, you might want to use those forests and jungle for other purposes, and you'll never get them back. Hey! Why the hell didn't they finish that? Bloody. So, I'm allied with Marrakesh. They'll be giving me some gems in the near future. And they are... they're mercantile, right? Yep. So they give me porcelain and gems. Sweet. I might even get extra influence from this one, but they improve their gems. That would be fun. So anyways, got anything to tell you about the new expansion? Religion. Oh yeah, I can build a polder here, and they're doing that right now. I don't have any iron, it seems. Here's iron. I do need iron if I want to kill this guy. Lots of iron. And there's none here. So I'll be building a city here, I suppose. And there's some iron, some stone, wheels, fish. Two fish. Be a good spot, mostly because I need iron. So, so engineer now, shall we? La 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 la. Heal up the warrior. There's nowhere I can go with this archer at the moment. It's gonna only move in coastal waters. Might be able to reach something here. Let's see. Maybe here. Maybe there's a little passage to the other continent. Three, 7 to 9. That one's probably playing culturally, although not so very good, I think. I'm actually playing culturally in another game, as Egypt.
The ancient oracle said that I was the wisest of all the Greeks.
Bloody.
Instrumental or mechanical science is the noblest, and above all the others, the most...
What's happened? Whoa. Alright. Policy. I'll go for... honor, commerce. Go for commerce. It's 25% gold in the capital. It's a nice boost for now. Another policy, maintenance paid on roads. Extra movement for naval units. I don't have any naval units yet. So we're going for this one. Choose production. The Colossus. Or settler. So yeah, we're building a settler. It's only 3 turns. So markets. Yeah. Why does it say it produces 6 gold here? Oh wait, my golden age ended. That's why I get less gold from this. Oh, wait a minute. I'll make a working boat to get some more pearls. Civil service looks like it's really good. I can go for that one. So anyway, in this other game I was playing culturally, and that's actually it's actually a real pain in the ass, especially because I'm playing at difficulty 6. That's quite hard. Let's see. Not yet. Maybe next turn. And in that game, the bloody William has the most points by far in the game, and he gets like plus 700-900 gold per turn. Really crazy. But well, I'm still holding out. National College. Well, no, that won't be working. Because I'm making another city in like 3 turns. 4. I'll go for the... I'll make a barracks. Because I'm going to war. Going to war. War. Sweet. Where'd they get that from? Specialists. Oh. Cool. Alright. There'll be one great tile improvement. Killing a jungle for it. Because it's next to a river. Gives him some gold. And also extra food, I think, if I remove the jungle.
The only thing that saves us.
Or no. Extra production. Less food. So you plus 1 production, minus 1 food. That was like great tile improvements. Especially because it's still quite early in the game. And well, to be honest, the great artists are pretty useless otherwise. I mean, you can expand your borders, but what's that good for? Nothing really. Because they expand automatically, and you can even buy tiles for a couple of gold. I won't get that one. Alhambra seems quite good to me. Oh, what's that? The Pakal created bloody religion. Yeah, he did. Buddhism. Okay. Want my religion to be dominant. Although, I'm quite convinced it won't be. I won't be the. Utrecht. Let's go for the watermill. Shall we? More population. Monuments. Always a monument. Jerusalem. Great prophet. Let's see what will I get? Our allies. Nah. Plenty of gold, but I'm not planning on spending that on city states. Now, oh yeah, see what the what's happened here? 133 because of the gems, and I think they also wanted a great artist. That is cool. They provided gems themselves, and then I got bonus from. Because they wanted gems. Pretty funny. So anyway, I'm not sure. Do I need? No, I don't need iron for knights. So actually, I don't think I need iron at all. Because knights are way stronger than. Hey, what's that? Need to attack me, bloody bastard! I'm the one that's attacking, not you. GTFO. Oh, that's actually pretty good. Plus one from horses, sheep, and cattle. As you can see, I have one horses and two cattle here, so it's plus three production. Plus 15% of building mounted units. Which I will be doing. That's just a scout. Oh, see, my workers are already going there to improve the iron resource. Iron isn't actually that useful anymore, because you don't need iron for catapults anymore. So you only need them for swordsmen and... Yeah, see? No iron needed for catapults, only for swordsmen. So, iron is bloody useless. That's a bit disappointing, actually. Oh. Crap. Go for machinery, which gives me access to crossbowmen. Oh. I have no idea how long I'm recording right now. Probably for 120 minutes already. So I think I'll wrap this up right now. No. Catapults. Oh, I was going to upgrade this one. This bugger. So anyway, some gold to Rio. gives me plus 50% influence, which will make me allies for a couple of turns. So anyway, I'll wrap this episode up, and I'll be seeing you next time. Most literate. Yay! I'm the most literate. Bye.